2018 Alfa Romeo Stelvio Quadrifoglio First Drive Review. Alfa Romeo re-entered the US market in a stunning way. Dismissing the fun but irrelevant 4C for a moment, the Giulia hit the premium compact sports sedan market like a hand grenade, shattering both preconceived notions and expectations. Why would you have a BMW 3 Series when for the same money you could have the better looking, better driving, better sounding, and an oh-so-fabulously Italian equivalent? Badge loyalty. Cases in point, the turbocharged 4-cylinder Giulia sedan beat out 8 competitors in one of our big tests. The geared up, 505 horsepower Quadrifoglio version bested the relevant competition in a head-to-head, plus a 6th place showing at last year's best driver's car, out of 12, as the lone sedan, and it beat out all the other new cars to take home the industry's most coveted award, our own Motor Trend Car of the Year. Alfa then followed up the Giulia with the Stelvio, one of the prettiest SUVs the world has ever seen. What did we think? Some of us really liked it. It flows around curves like massage oil over bare flesh, Scott Evans purred. A slightly less torn on Angus McKenzie said, refined, sporty, the Stelvio is a 21st century Gran Turismo that can take you along all roads in all weather, at speed and in comfort. Additionally, thanks to some quirks and electrical bugs in an early build T-Sport, the Stelvio just missed being named our 2018 SUV of the Year. Based on all that, one might jump to the conclusion that the Stelvio Quadrifoglio, by virtue of ditching the 280 horsepower 2.0-liter turbocharged i4 in favor of a 505 horsepower 2.9-liter twin-turbo V6, ought to be one gobsmackingly great SUV, right? The engine certainly doesn't hurt anything. In addition to the 505 Italian stallions, the Stelvio Q4, as it's badged, comes packing 443 pounds to foot of torque, available from 2,500 to 5,000 revolutions per minute. The Quadrifoglio also sports a beefed-up version of the ZF8-speed automatic transmission featuring an all-wheel drive transfer case and massive column-mounted aluminum paddles. The computers, known as chassis domain control and Alfa Speed, can vary the torque split as needed. 100% of the twisting force can be diverted to the rear wheels, as well as up to 60% of the torque to the fronts. There's also torque vectoring rear axle, which can overdrive either outside rear tire by 50%.